The caterpillars of browntail moth cause a poison ivy-like rash in most individuals.
I'm Allison Canody. I'm a forest entomologist with the Maine Forest Service, and I'm here today to control browntail moth caterpillars. And you may wonder why I'm standing out here in the snow on a cold, blustery day looking for caterpillars, but this is the best time of year to manage populations when you have them in places that you can reach. You can cut and destroy the overwintering webs of the caterpillars and reduce the populations locally using those methods. So this is a overwintering web of the browntail moth. The caterpillars are inside, just as if they were in a nice little Arctic sleeping bag, all cozied up together, and they're dormant. They will emerge in the spring when the tree buds begin to swell, and they'll feed on the leaves there can be anywhere from 25 to 400 caterpillars. So you can just clip the webs right out of the trees. And then you don't want to just put them on the ground. You want to collect them in a paper bag or a bucket and then destroy them either by soaking them overnight in a soapy water solution or burning them in your wood stove. Or some communities even have community bonfires where they get rid of a whole bunch of brown tails that way.
The area impacted by browntail moth in Maine has expanded in recent years. Look at the map and see if they've been found in your town, but more importantly, look at the trees around where you live and see if there are overwintering webs in them. Clipping those webs now can save you an awful lot of discomfort in the spring and summer.